An update for the Philadelphia Eagles as we are waiting for Eagles training camp. And I cannot be more excited. So more news on some acquisitions. And obviously, how did Howie get this done? Let's check it out. What is going on, guys? Your boy Joey Shake 72 coming to you guys with a video right now. So I want to go over the Philadelphia Eagles and just looking at some players. And I think one we have to kind of really look at is Kaiser White. And you know, we picked him up in free agency this past year. Now, the whole star of this whole thing on the linebackers, which before, you know, free agency started, we didn't know what was going to happen. We knew that linebacker was a huge need, and the Eagles, you know, released Alex Singleton. You know, I didn't think that was going to happen. I think that was the start of me saying, as soon as they released Alex Singleton, I knew that they wanted change. I knew that they wanted to somewhat change this position by a mile, and it was a big problem. Kaiser White wasn't supposed to be available for the Philadelphia Eagles. Even how he said it at a press conference after acquiring him in free agency down the road a little bit in free agency, that he said that he didn't think that Kaiser White would have been available. Now, we all know that the Chargers revamped their defense. You know, their second level of linebackers aren't as great. And the Chargers were pushing to re-sign him. And it wasn't going to be for a lot of money, you know, because they were spending a lot of money offensively and obviously revamped that defense. And, you know, the Chargers are definitely a Super Bowl contender going into this season. But you know, have some weaknesses at linebacker. Kaiser White, you know, I don't know if they want to give him a new contract. It looked like that they really tried to push for a new contract for Kaiser White, a short-term deal, but not expensive for the money they've already spent on that team, you know, on certain positions already, to make that big Super Bowl run. And the fans were very pissed off. Okay, so the new news coming out to this whole thing is, do not turn your head, you know, turn your heads on, you know, Kaiser White. Like I'm saying, like, you got to pay attention to him because he could play middle linebacker, outside linebacker. He can make the calls for your defense. His coverage ain't that bad. He's a tackling machine. He's physical. And he wants to come back and play for his favorite team. And that's the whole thing, is what happened to a couple players that want to come back and play for Philadelphia. Yeah, so kind of like Hassan Reddick, that could have went to another team for a lot of money and decided to come here on a cheaper deal because we wouldn't have been able to. We probably would have been able to sign his contract, but the Eagles probably wanted to, you know, sign other guys, and they got him on a discount, definitely. And obviously, he was the, you know, the 13th pick in that draft in 17, the one right before Derek Barnett. So just to give an example on players I want to play in Philly, just because they've always wanted to play in this city. I think Kaiser White is actually from Philadelphia. I think I could be wrong if I could remember, if I could recall. But this was a huge deal for Howie Roseman. And I think now adding, you know, more with Hassan Reddick moving from Sam linebacker to edge rusher, you know, having TJ Edwards, that's been pretty damn solid. I'm so pissed off that TJ Edwards never really had a bigger chance. Even with Jim Schwartz, he never really gave him a chance, and he flashed and flashed and flashed. And, you know, Jim Schwartz just played, you know, just had veteran favoritism and played guys that didn't deserve to play. Unfortunately. So, you know, and then adding N'Kobe Dean in the third round was just a total steal. So at this point, I think you're going to have really good, healthy competition at linebacker. Okay. They won't tell you this, but Charger fans are really pissed off at this linebacker position for them right now, especially, you know, with Kaiser White not re-signing with them and how big of a deal that was for them, for him not to come back. And I think the Eagles, you know, were surprised that they got him. Even Howie said, like, they didn't think they were going to get him. They didn't think it was even possible. Thank God, you know, he loves the Philadelphia Eagles and it's his favorite team. And to play with his favorite team is a good thing for him. And it helped us out. It's a one-year deal. So, you know, TJ Edwards, you know, has only got a contract throughout this year. Kaiser White, a contract through this year. You know what I mean? So, you know, I feel like there will be a re-sign. You know what I mean? You have N'Kobe Dean for another 3 years after this year. So, I mean, you have some time to, you know, see who's going to be your guy, who are going to be your guys at linebacker here, and really shape this group up to be a big, strong suit other than a weakness for years. I think this is going to be the year where they're going to find out which guys are really going to step up. I think training camp is definitely going to help that. I mean, definitely going to watch preseason and see, you know, what these kids could do. But when you go into the past and you go into what the Eagles have done at the linebacker position, they really just kept everything the same. They really not acquired. I think Davion Taylor was a big acquisition, you know, a couple years ago, but unfortunately they barely used him. I mean, that's just, you know, they draft guys, they barely use them, and that's what they did. You know, TJ Edwards was undrafted and they barely used him. And then when he played, he showed a lot of good flashes, but just, I guess, because of the coaching, and I don't know who had more control over this roster, or maybe Doug had something to do with it or something in the past, but, you know, there was just a lot of issues on producing players, so we couldn't really tell if Howie Roseman's drafting, which definitely was, but there's a lot of other things that go into that, well as was Howie Roseman controlled, or did he not have the final say, or did he not have, you know, did he butt heads with Andy Wydell or Jeffrey Lurie, which it seems like that may be the case right now, because this position has suffered. I mean, we haven't had a good linebacker in here since, you know, Michael Kendricks when he was healthy at times. You know, I thought Nigel Bradham was a beast, you know, here, you know, Jeremiah Trotter. I mean, they've had some really good linebackers come in this building, but, you know, the Eagles made some changes. And after that Alex Singleton release, that really showed me that they were really trying to make a change at this position. I just didn't know what was going to happen. You know what I mean? So I feel like when you have Davion Taylor coming back from injury, you have TJ Edwards had a solid year last year, and I think it's just going to play better this year. Kaiser White comes in. If you guys remember, we signed that Jatavis Brown. I forgot his name. The linebacker from the Chargers, I think last year, that was supposed to be here with us last year on a one-year deal. He ended up retiring. So we kind of lost a veteran linebacker last year just because of retirement, which really sucks. But this one definitely hurts the Chargers. This one definitely hurts the Charger fans. They lost a good player, and a player that the rumors are behind it that the Chargers really pushed hard. And it seems like Kaiser White ignored everything. And he already had his mindset set on another team. I think he wants to make his name somewhere else. And not saying that he doesn't think that the Eagles defense is going to be good this year, because I think every player thinks that. But I think he just wants to plant his own name somewhere. And I understand, he probably understood that he was going to have a lot of pieces around him with that Chargers defense. I understand that, but I feel like he wants to rebrand his name somewhere else. I mean, he was a fourth round pick, you know what I mean? So, I mean, he has a chip. I think he has a chip on his shoulder. I've seen some mic'd up moments where he's just always at it. And he always has that high energy with him, which I really do like. So what do you guys think about Kaiser White? And just in order from the linebackers, which ones do you think that will make this team, and what positions will they play at the linebacker position, obviously? And where do you think they'll, you know, Jonathan Gannon will use these players, you know, to their advantage in this hybrid scheme? So it should be really interesting what they're doing. Just wanted to give my focal point on just some of the rumors behind this signing of Kaiser White back in free agency and this linebacker group in general. And I think you could finally get this linebacker core back to what it was, and not making it a weakness, making it a big, strong point. And finally, you know, actually doing something with this position. This was a roster last year that only kept seven linebackers last year going into the season. We all were like, why are they keeping seven linebackers? Just to find that right combination of who would step up. And I thought that Davion Taylor and TJ Edwards really stepped up last year. And now adding these new pieces, now I think it's really going to make a huge difference. And it's really up to Jonathan Gannon, because really, if these players are not being successful, if there's multiple players that I know that could play and they're not being successful, I'm not really going to blame the players. I'm going to blame Jonathan Gannon and how he's using this defense. So this whole second step to this thing, one, you have to produce these players. Number two, do they fit the scheme? And number three, is Jonathan Gannon doing his job as a defensive coordinator? So I think that's what's going to be really important. So let me guys know what you guys think about, you know, Jonathan Gannon, the linebacker situation in general, and, you know, TJ Edwards, Kaiser White, one-year deals, not going to be, you know, could not, you know, maybe won't be here next year. You know, just the future of this linebacker core, and how high are you guys about it? So, other than that, guys, pretty much it. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Chicks, what up, follow, so peace out, guys. Peace.